ESPN 94.1 FM at AM 930 present The Drive.
Pretty big day for Friday, don't you think? We've got layoffs at ESPN. We have got a new softball coach being presented to the herd faithful. And, of course, we've got me. Welcome in. It's the Friday edition of the show. Paul Swann, your host, here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. It was fun today. 10 a.m., we're over at the big green room at the football stadium, and Christian Spears, Marshall's athletic director, is introducing someone that most of us don't need an introduction. She's Morgan Zerkle. She's your new softball coach. So she is back as the coach. Fifth head coach in Marshall softball history. Spent her previous four seasons at Miami of Ohio as an assistant coach. And the Redhawks got to three consecutive MAC championships and NCAA tournament appearances. And so she's back. This is a big dream for her. We're going to hear, get this, we're going to hear from her in just a few minutes. I've got a couple of highlights from the presser. And I also, at 5:30, I've got her on the show. I wasn't even expecting her until maybe Monday or Tuesday, but we got her today. So she's going to be on the program. We're going to talk about it. It was a pretty big day. Good crowd on hand. I was happy to see it. Good crowd for Marshall softball. Again, Marshall softball is one of those growth sports. The sport is growing. It's becoming more popular. People are realizing there's a lot to be seen here. And so hopefully this is a growth sport for the Thundering Herd. And a lot of people were rooting for Morgan Zerkle to be hired as the head coach. And Christian Spears, Marshall's athletic director, heard you. We'll get into that a little bit later on. Of course, we'll also get your text in. 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. So do you think that it's a home run? Now that we've had a few days to think about it, go over it, talk about it, do you think it's going to be a home run for the Thundering Herd and for Coach Zerkle to have her back, someone who's very passionate about the Thundering Herd, a place that gave her so many opportunities, and she talked about that in her speech today. One thing I'll say about her is you know she has a passion for it, and you know that she cares, wants to do a great job. Big deal for her. It really is a big deal for her. You get to come back home and be the head coach of your school. So absolutely a big deal for her. I don't know if it was just her emotions or what it was, but you could tell in her voice. You could hear and feel the emotion coming from her. Now get her out there on the softball field. Watch out. There's not going to be any of that, right? She is locked in and ready to go. But she was definitely in a good place emotionally, though. You could hear it and you can tell it in her voice today that this really meant something to her. And that was actually good to see. That was cool to see, actually. I like it when you can tell that the person that you're speaking to has a passion about something and that it means something to them. I mean, a lot of things mean a lot to different people, different degrees. But for her, this is a real big opportunity, and I don't think that this is a hire that if it goes well, she's not going to necessarily be looking for the next job anytime soon. If this goes well, she's going to be really happy to be the head coach of Marshall University. And sometimes that's not a bad thing. You have coaches that come in and they do a lot for the program and then they go to the next stop, and you have other coaches that come in and they do a lot for the program and then they stay because the program means a lot to them. And so I think you're going to have that with Morgan Zerkle. So we'll get into that a little bit later on in the program. She's coming on about 5:30, so I'm looking forward to talking to her. We've got baseball action for you tonight right here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. The Pirates beat the Padres yesterday 5-4. The Bucks now play host to the Brewers tonight, 7:05. Listen to it right here on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. The Reds had Thursday off, and they're in action right now. Of course, you don't care because you're listening to me, and I like it that way. Thank you. Atlantic League action. Charleston beats Spire City 10-2. The Dirty Birds remain home as they play host to Lancaster tonight, 6:35. That's going to be at Go Mart Ballpark. And, of course, we have NASCAR action coming up this weekend for you on Big Buck Country 101.5. NASCAR on the Chicago Street Course. Xfinity, the Loop 121 Saturday at 5. For the Cup, it's the Grant Park 220 Sunday at 5:30. And again, that's on our sister station, Big Buck Country 101.5. So we're going to hear in just a few minutes from Marshall Athletic Director Christian Spears, a couple of his comments from today's event. I told you I was going to ask him what it was that made him say, this is the hire. I'm giving her the job. Of all the candidates, what it is about her that made her the right choice. And no, I'm not talking about the mayor of Barbersville publicly posting on his Facebook page. You wouldn't know that if you're not his friend. I am. Seriously, my guy, the mayor of Barbersville, Chris Tatum, who, dear friend of mine, but also a very important political figure in the region, was even lobbying on social media for the job to be given to Morgan Zerkle. Talk about references, right? Absolutely. I would love it to have the mayor of Huntington, the mayor of Barbersville, lobbying for me on something. Maybe I can get those guys to do it for me. Issue a proclamation or something, one of those letters of reference, or just get them to really endorse me on social media. Either way, that's a pretty big deal. A lot of people, and you'll hear that from Christian Spears, not directly referencing the mayor, mind you, but you'll hear that from him and some of the comments that we're going to play for you in just a few minutes, and also we'll hear later on from Morgan Zerkle. So we'll take our first break, come back, and we'll hear a little bit from the presser earlier today. And then we'll get your text in, 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. All of that's coming up on this edition of The Drive, ESPN 94.1 and AM 930.
This is The Drive with Paul Swann on ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930.
Our text line this hour, 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. Still to come, we're going to hear directly from the new softball coach, Marshall University, Morgan Zerkle. She's coming up about 5:30, so we'll talk to her about the job. She's been on the job for a few days. This was sort of the formal introduction. She's someone that really doesn't need an introduction to the Marshall faithful. She was one of the standouts on the Marshall squad from 2014 to 2017. She's had a successful run as an assistant coach. She's also someone who's played at a high level of softball. So she's going to bring a lot of knowledge and a lot of potential networking opportunities, I think, with who she knows and what she knows. So that's going to be a big deal to have her mentoring the future softball players at the next level and hopefully on the way to several conference championships and beyond. So she joins coming up in about 12 minutes or so. So looking forward to that. I was at the event earlier today with Marshall University Athletic Director Christian Spears as the Thundering Herd making the announcement, making it official. It was officially official today. And so we'll skip past his introductory comments. We'll skip past that. One of the things that I said that I would ask him, so I did get the opportunity, was how did she fit? What was it about Morgan Zerkle that made you pass on other candidates? Maybe candidates that have coached longer, candidates that have had coaching experience, candidates that maybe have a good resume of wins and losses, everything that you would look for in a coach. you found in Morgan Zerkle because you made the hire. So I asked Athletic Director Christian Spears to just talk about what it was about her that made him decide she's the one, I got to pick her.
Yeah, this is always going to be consistent, Paul, and something that Deborah and I have been doing while we've been together, you know, at so many different stops along the way. And does the person have a sincere connection to the place? Does the person have a sincere connection to the people in our community? And what is their passion and what is their purpose? And do they know that? And Morgan actually hits every single box. It never happens that way. It is hard to find someone who actually has a sincere connection to the place, a sincere connection to the people in the community, knows her purpose, and has an enormous passion. Morgan does all of that. It was an absolute no-brainer because she fits right into our philosophy on bringing great people to Marshall.
So you heard Christian Spears. She just clicked all the boxes. Yeah. Does she fit this? Click. Does she fit this? Click. All of them. And if you ask a lot of people, when this job opening became available, when this job opening was first announced, we knew that there would be some names out there that Herd fans might be interested in. And Morgan Zerkle was the name that most people were talking about. As I mentioned, and I wasn't joking, I'm friends with Chris Tatum. He's the mayor of Barbersville. So you know that he's got a voice. He's even putting it out there. Hey, get on this already. Let's go. Let's make this happen. Morgan Zerkle, bring her here. A lot of fans on social media. Let's make this happen. Let's go. What are you doing? Morgan Zerkle, hire her already. And when when Athletic Director Christian Spears was asked about how much interest there was in the program, he said that there was a lot of interest in the program from candidates, but it all came back to hire Morgan Zerkle.
You know, this community told me who to hire, right? On multiple different occasions. If I can count the number of emails, direct messages I got, texts, even dear friends who are like, what are you doing? Like, hurry up. What's going on? Do this, right? Board members, the president. Yeah, it was, this is the quintessential no-brainer. But you do want people to go through a process. You do want to see how someone manages and stands up on our own 2 feet. I can tell you what, we left that room that day with Morgan, so impressed by her. Again, like I was ready to hire her the moment she finished the conversation with Brad.
So she gets the job. And when she took the podium, if you were with me earlier, I talked a little bit about, and I'll talk about it again, how you could hear the emotion in her voice, how you could hear, and she even alluded to the fact that she was just going to come up and just shoot straight, say what was on her mind, but she did, at the behest of several, she prepared her statement a little bit, so she had notes, because she knew that this was an emotional moment for her. This is a special moment for her. And so you could hear it in her voice as she talked about becoming the new coach at Marshall University.
I am truly honored to be the head softball coach of Marshall University. Marshall and the people here have developed me into the person, the player, the coach that I am today. And there was a lot of development that happened. I'm forever grateful for this university. It was my dream to play Division I softball, and Marshall gave me that opportunity. Marshall provided a way for me to get drafted to play professionally and to get a tryout with Team USA, which was another dream come true as well. Marshall showed me what career I was really interested in, developing young women like myself. And now here I am living out another one of my dreams as, you know, the next Marshall head softball coach.
You hear that emotion in her voice? It's real. I can see it on her face. It's real. She is passionate about this job. This was a dream job for her. This was a dream, not just a dream job. It's a dream of hers. Hey, maybe one day I can become the coach of Marshall University softball. Maybe I can be that person. I can be the next one mentoring young ladies and developing these young ladies into future leaders or whatever those aspirations are. You could hear in her voice that, hey, this was where I wanted to go on my journey, and now she's here. So we'll talk to her in a few short minutes. I'm looking forward to it. We'll get your text in, 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. We'll talk a little bit later on as well about several layoffs with ESPN. They're going to be impactful. The sports landscape is changing. And, of course, there's a lot of money going on here. The layoffs are happening today. It's not just ESPN. Of course, it's the parent company, Disney, trying to reduce spending $5.5 billion. I'm looking at that number, and I still wonder where they're going to be able to cut and still be a nimble company. $5.5 billion worldwide. And these job cuts are aimed at managing costs and what they're describing is ensuring future growth. So we'll go over some of the names a little bit later on. Some big names on the list, including Susie Colbert. I didn't think they would ever dare cut Susie Colbert. She's one of the smartest people in the room at all times, and she does a fantastic job. So there's some really good names, talented people, and they didn't lose their job because of their talent or lack thereof. They lost their jobs because of cost cutting. It's not fun. I've been through it. And I sympathize and empathize with everyone in their situation right now. It's not fun when you walk into an office and you're told, hey, look, by no fault of your own, we're going to eliminate your position because we just can't afford to pay you. It's always terrible to lose your job. Hopefully, these people will bounce back. So we'll talk about some of the names. And honestly, if you believe it, you can achieve it. You will bounce back. If you don't let it get you, you will bounce back. All right, enough of me philosophizing here. When we continue, we're going to talk softball with the new head coach of Marshall University, Morgan Zerkle. We'll do that when we continue on this edition of The Drive, ESPN 94.1 at AM 930. Do you want to make a podcast? Spotify's got a platform. It lets you make one super easily, then distribute it everywhere and even earn money all in one place for free. It's called Spotify for Podcasters, and here's how it works. Spotify for Podcasters lets you record and edit podcasts right from your phone or computer, so no matter what your setup is like, you can start creating today. Then you can distribute your podcast to Spotify and everywhere else podcasts are heard. And video podcasts are also available on Spotify. So if you do a video podcast, upload it. It'll be an audio podcast just like that. With Spotify for Podcasters, you can earn money in a variety of ways, including ads and podcast subscriptions. And best of all, it's totally free with no catch. I love free with no catch. And ever since I discovered Spotify for Podcasters, I feel like I've got options. I highly recommend you give it a try, too. Find out what options are available for you. Download the Spotify for Podcasters app or go to Spotify.com/podcasters to get started.
This is The Drive with Paul Swann on ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930.
Welcome back to our Friday edition. It's The Drive on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. We'll open up our text line in just a few minutes for you. 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. But I want to welcome to the program now. It's her first appearance as the head coach of the Marshall University softball team. It's the fifth coach in the history of Marshall softball. It's Morgan Zerkle. How are you doing? It's been good seeing you all around these last few days and see you finally formally introduced today.
I've been doing great. You know, it's super exciting. I feel, you know, the support from the community and everyone around me. the Marshall athletic staff, people. It's been really awesome.
When you found out that there were so many people lobbying for you, not just maybe people in your network, close friends, but people in the community. I was joking with the mayor of Barbersville on text that, yes, you know, your lobbying was seen as well, as Christian Spears even joked about how everyone told him to hire you. Mm-hmm. What does that feel like to know that there are so many people lobbying for you?
You know, I just feel loved, you know. I know that, you know, I have been at Marshall and in Huntington a long time, and to know that, you know, I made some sort of impact while I was here, that many people, you know, wanted me to return, it's a really special feeling, and I couldn't be more thankful for everyone's efforts to get me back to Marshall.
Has it been a whirlwind today? You can hear it in your voice now, and I know when we were talking to you earlier this morning, you could hear it in your voice, just the love and passion you have, and knowing that this is a big moment for you.
Yeah, to have this opportunity at such a great time in my life is phenomenal. And to be able to come home and do what I love, coach and play and serve this university, I couldn't have dreamt it up any better.
So now your trajectory has been pretty rapid. You go from playing at Marshall, having a successful career. People will talk about your career long after we're all gone, how successful you were. You go to the next level, Team USA, you have opportunities at the professional level, you're in the coaching ranks now, and you're still pretty young. So it just feels like it's been an express elevator to get to this point. Did you think it would happen so fast?
No, I definitely didn't think it would happen this fast. You know, I knew Marshall was doing great things. You know, I didn't foresee the previous coach, you know, leaving quite so soon. But when the opportunity came about, you know, there's nothing I wanted more. So I believe in great timing. And if it's meant to happen now, it was meant to happen. So even though I didn't expect it, it's awesome.
Do you feel that you're ready for this position, that this is the right moment for you as a person, that here I am? You mentioned if it's meant to be, it's meant to be. You're ready for this.
Yes, I believe wholeheartedly in that. I knew from the second I started coaching that I wanted to be a head coach and I wanted to lead others and develop them how I was developed. So I knew pretty on that's what I wanted to do, and I think I've been preparing for several years, even though I've been assistant, that this is something I ultimately wanted to do, and to do it at Marshall is just even better. So I feel more than ready to take on this challenge.
Putting a coaching staff together, you're almost complete. I know because of university policies, you can't name anyone until they're official, but can we expect familiar names, or will they be people that you know but not necessarily Marshall fans would know directly?
I'm not really sure. I think it'll be a mix. I think you may know the names. You know, the softball world is pretty small and tight-knit, so there's some great names. You can expect probably some young faces, but people who are fired up to get into the profession, to coach young women, and to do it alongside me. I know I have a great candidate pool for this team, and I'm excited about, you know, the wealth of knowledge that they're going to bring to the athletes, as well as the inspirational piece and the relatability piece. I think we'll hit that head on the nail.
So what does a Morgan Zerkle team look like once you get everything in place the way you want?
That's a great question. I want to be athletic. I think that's important to me, is to have a bunch of athletes. I would like a mix, you know, of power and speed. I think I'm a pretty well-rounded mix of both now, but if I could keep my speed athletes and keep my power athletes and get a great mix there, that would be great. But ultimately, I just want competitive athletes who are willing to get after it, who are coachable, and I'm, you know, willing to develop whoever wants to be coached. So I'm excited to just get some athletic kids that are very coachable.
Did you have to hit the ground running as you come into the program and trying to make sure that the team you have is still at this juncture going to be the team you have when the season rolls around with your additions?
Yes, definitely. That was something I wanted to try to preserve for sure. We had a great group last year, and to be able to keep, you know, a good core of them is important to me and fill any gaps where needed, but definitely, you know, wanted to meet the team as soon as I, you know, got hired, and then go from there as far as doing all the things that need to be done to make sure we're, you know, well-rounded and good to go for this next season.
It's not been that long since you were a player, but as a player, you didn't have the transfer portal opportunities or the name, image, and likeness opportunities that are out there now. How has that changed from your point of view, and is it good, bad, or can it be better?
I definitely think it can be better. You know, there's the pros and cons to anything, and I think a lot of people, you know, are seeing the negatives in it, but you've also seen some really great success stories with transfers. I know Marshall has a few right now that are very successful and doing well. So I think there can be good in it for sure. And, you know, like I said, if I have any specific needs, I would plan to use it. So it could be improved, you know, as anything. But I think in time, you know, the NCAA will figure it out, and hopefully it'll be used for a good thing.
One of the things that Christian Spears alluded to, and we're talking with Morgan Zerkle, she was announced officially today as Marshall's softball coach, is the fact that you have that ability to go out and use your network. What specifically was he alluding to as far as your ability to network?
You know, like I said earlier, the softball world is small, but we span far across the country, and I've been able to play, you know, in the pro league for 7 years now. So all the athletes that I've played with in the pro league, you know, those are great, great resources right there. I still play in a pro league with 60 athletes. So, you know, that's a great network to have, as well as the coaches I've played for, from the universities I've worked at to being on the national team and working alongside those coaches. I've been able to, you know, be close to a lot of those and have a lot of good mentors and resources that I can always rely on.
And to play off that, since you mentioned it's a small world, how do you capitalize on that? And what are you able to do, or do you believe that you can do, to maybe give you an advantage?
You know, I think being a pro athlete is just important, that because I do see myself very relatable to the student athletes now. I've not only been in their shoes at Marshall, but I'm still in their shoes in a lot of ways, you know, dealing with, you know, training and recovery and managing time. That's very relatable. So I think, you know, that's seen as advantage to me, because I think athletes want coaches who understand them and can relate to them. So I see that as an advantage. And just, you know, being able to play on ESPN and have my athletes watch me, that's a pretty cool recruiting tool as well, to be able to use.
My guest, newly named Marshall softball coach Morgan Zerkle, coming home to take the job. And as you mentioned, you're still playing, so it's not as if you've just hung that up and you're done and you're just going to do this coaching thing now. You can still go, and that's going to give you an advantage as well, because you can get out there, and a lot of coaches can do this, but you're at that point in your career right now where you could probably go out there and really show them how it's done, and they might have to work hard to get to your level.
Yeah, I want to challenge them for sure. I think we have some athletes, you know, that are capable of getting to that next level, and to be able to show them that it's possible, and it's possible at Marshall, and the path I had can be an example, but there's also many ways they can create their own path. I hope to be a great inspiration to them, and to show them that you can do a lot of things at our university.
Speaking of the university, there have been changes since you've been gone. And again, you haven't been gone that long, but there are things that are changing. You see construction right next door to the softball field. You've seen a lot of different improvements that the university has gone through with Marshall's new athletic department. What has stood out the most to you?
Well, obviously, you know, adding the baseball field, taking out, you know, that whole area beside the softball field, it just looks completely different over there. And it's still, you know, ground level, but I'm so excited to see that area built up into something special to surround the softball field and be a really cool complex and just place for the athletes to train and hang out and, you know, a nice area. That's going to be huge. I'm excited for that, as well as, you know, all the new restaurants around campus and coffee shops and cool places. It's cool to just see the town growing, and I know that'll help us, you know, in recruiting and all that.
Morgan Zerkle's with us, the new head coach of the Marshall softball team. So I'm not trying to get you in trouble with this question, but if there wasn't an evident forward momentum with the program, not just with wins and losses, but the investment in the program, would you have maybe passed on this opportunity if you didn't believe that you can move forward?
I mean, it was definitely a dream job of mine, but I think all the things that they told me about, you know, their vision for updating facilities and this and the expectations of the program to grow, that made it a no-brainer for me. I think if they would have not supported, you know, me playing, that would have been tough, but that was the opposite. I felt very supported in that. So it would have taken a lot for me to say no. But luckily I didn't have to go that route because I felt, you know, overwhelmed with support in so many areas, and I'm very excited about, you know, the vision of this program and the school and everything I heard.
Morgan Zirkle's with us, new head coach of the Marshall softball team. So you felt the love and overwhelmed. How's your family feeling about all this?
Oh, they're, you know, ecstatic. You know, I couldn't be a better place for me to start my head coaching career with the support of my family, you know, so close to me. And they're excited. I'm excited to, you know, be close to my siblings, have my niece and nephew who are young to be able to visit them. My grandparents, I just, you know, they're super happy to have me close, and I'm happy to have them as well.
So you're going to have a built-in cheering section all to yourself at the Dot.
Absolutely, yes.
Morgan Zirkle's with us. You can hear in her voice she's excited about being the head coach of the Marshall Thundering Herd. And what's next for you? What's tomorrow look like? What's a week from now look like for you? As obviously we've got the holiday coming up with the 4th of July, but holidays really don't mean anything when you're a coach or if you're a player.
Right. You know, I hope to get out and recruit a little bit, maybe have some athletes on campus. I definitely want to take care of my team and finish getting to know those current players. That's very important to me, so I want to do that first. And then, you know, just go from there. I do have a playing season I've committed to in August, so I'll be doing that, you know, next month. But really just going through all the things that need done to get this program ready to go for when the student-athletes are back on campus.
I want to follow up on that, if you don't mind. With the playing career, you've got the opportunity to continue to be on the field and be an active player. How do you manage that, being a coach, a player, and trying to juggle it all?
You know, I love this question because I get it a lot from my peers who are interested in coaching and playing. And I always tell them, you know, it's as hard as you make it. It's as stressful as you make it. And if you're organized and you're able to, you know, separate the different things and dedicate a certain time to working, a certain time to training and playing yourself, it's very doable. But if you stress out about it and you get upset when you can't juggle, you know, that's on you. But if you manage those things, it's very doable. And I'm super excited to show people that you can be a head coach. athlete and do other things as well, have family time and all of that. So I'm excited to continue to juggle the awesome things that I'm getting to do.
Not to get into the weeds too much, but what are some of the things that you have to juggle? How do you specifically go about a day?
Right. While I'm in playing season, you know, this coming season, we'll be playing Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday through Thursday, you know, is practicing, is office time in my hotel room. So it's really just, you know, waking up and saying, you know, this morning I'm going to, you know, work on team stuff for a few hours, and then I'm going to relax and get my mind right for practice, and then, you know, games on the weekend. So it's just kind of dividing up your time, and when you're working on one thing, giving that one thing 100% of your attention, and that way you can accomplish a lot. I like to say I'm a very efficient person, so if you work efficiently, that helps too. You don't have to, you know, spend 8 hours in an office to accomplish a task, but if you work efficiently and you're paying attention to what you're doing, you can do a lot in a few hours.
Do you also have a lot of maybe unofficial assistant coaches with you, with coaching staffs and teams, with you know, when you're playing professionally?
Yeah, athletes and women is a great resource. I like to say it's like professional development, because you're around so many great athletes and great minds that you can feed off each other, learn from each other, you know, potentially get assistance, right? And it's a really cool environment to be able to grow the sport, but also like grow each other within the league that we're playing in. And it's a great thing that we've got going.
Before I let you go, I need to ask that, since you brought it up. With the Sun Belt, it's going to be a little different than when you played. What's your impression so far?
I'm excited. I've seen, you know, some good competition and good RPI in the Sun Belt, so that's exciting to have that level of softball that we're going to be playing, you know. And we've had some great teams be successful. You've had Louisiana go to the World Series and JMU, and there's no reason Marshall can't be that next team and continually be that team. So hopefully we can get to that level, and being in the Sun Belt is just, you know, exciting that it's been done before, so let's be next.
My guest, Morgan Zerkle, new softball coach, Marshall University, presented the number 5 jersey today to signify her being the 5th head coach. It's fun. This was fun to do this today. It's been a while since we've been together in any form since you left as a player at Marshall, so it's going to be fun to have you around, and I'm sure that we're going to see a lot of people just lining up to come see you. Haven't seen you in a while, so I'm excited for you.
Yes, I hope so. Lots of fans of softball games this year, even more.
You want to break that Alabama record, don't you?
Absolutely. Records are meant to be broken. Let's do it.
Morgan Zerkle, my guest, thanks for doing this. I appreciate you doing it today on short notice, and we'll get you back soon, closer to the season or whenever something else is coming up.
All right. Thank you.
That's Morgan Zerkle, new softball coach, Marshall University. We'll get our final break in, and we'll come back, and we'll get your text in, 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. This is The Drive on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930.
This is The Drive with Paul Swann on ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930.
It's our final segment of this edition of The Drive on ESPN 94.1 and AM 930. It's been a long week. I'm glad we got through it. We'll be back with you on Monday. On Tuesday, it'll be Independence Day. That'll be the one day off this week for the show. But we'll be back with you on Monday as we kick you off into your Independence celebrations. We'll make time this week on the text line for you, 304-396-TALK, 304-396-8255. And, of course, you can find me on Twitter at Paul Swann. Good talking to her today. It was fun. It was really exciting. This is a big deal for her. Big dream come true. And it's always good when most people think that, all right, you did a good job, you hired the right candidate. And that's a good feeling to be able to build off of. And you've seen that as of late with some of the openings and the opportunities to fill them, what you've seen brought in as far as people and candidates. I think women's basketball, definitely a renewed energy and push for women's basketball. I think you're going to see the same with softball, all the facility improvements, and there's a lot more to do. It's not done. It's never going to be done. There's a lot more that needs to be done, and hopefully we're going to see that continually happening with this athletic department as it moves forward, trying to be the very best Sun Belt program it can be, and maybe beyond. Who knows? So good conversation today with Morgan Zerkle. Looking forward to having her back on. As I briefly mentioned, there were some layoffs today at ESPN as part of the parent company Disney's efforts to try to restructure the company. And some of your favorite voices on the radio will no longer be there. Jason Fitz is not going to be there anymore. Keyshawn Johnson is not going to be there anymore. Also, Max Kellerman, not going to be there anymore. Van Gundy, can you believe this one? Jeff Van Gundy, he's not going to be there anymore. Susie Colbert, not going to be there anymore. Todd McShay, he is an expert in scouting college football. He's been with ESPN since 2006. He's done some sideline reporting as well. He's not going to be there. Jalen Rose is not going to be there. I mean, that's huge. That's a big deal. I mean, Jalen Rose has been a part of First Take and Get Up, and he co-hosted Jalen and Jacoby. And that's been one of the more consistent shows with ESPN for a long time. So I don't know what to tell you. I don't know what our morning show is going to look like on the network side, as we are an affiliate of ESPN Radio. I hope you stick with us. I do hope that you are continuing to be a part of what we do here. But one of my favorite channels, one of my favorite radio stations right now, going through a lot of change, and I hate it, because these are all talented people. These are all talented people. So there are lots of talented people out there right now looking for the next opportunity. Hopefully it will continue to be in sports. If not, hopefully it'll be something that will allow them to go a different place and maybe find out there's something else they would like to do. But this is just crazy to see some of this talent today. And then you bring someone in like Pat McAfee, who is probably going to get a lot of heat because he's bringing in a different vibe and a different energy to ESPN, and he's getting paid a lot of money because of that ability. And so I'm sure there will be some that point to that and say, well, you're spending a lot of money here and you're not spending a lot of money here. So difficult day with ESPN and ABC, and we'll see how it all shakes out. But I do appreciate you staying here with me. And with that said, that's going to do it for this edition. Thanks for tuning in. It was a great treat today to talk to Morgan Zerkle, one of Marshall's all-time best, now coming back to become one of Marshall's all-time best, hopefully, as a coach as well. Marshall's been pretty good with softball coaches. I'll say that. Marshall has been very fortunate to bring in some quality people over the years, and let's hope that that trend definitely will continue, which I'm pretty confident will with Morgan Zerkle. And with all of that said, thanks for tuning in. It was good talking to you today. I had a great week with you. I'll be back on Monday. We're going to do it all over again. In the meanwhile, don't forget, we podcast this show. We do it daily. We also have a Twitter account that I invite you all to follow. It's real simple. You can find me at Paul Swann. Have a great weekend, everyone. I'll talk to you on Monday.
WRBC Huntington, W227BS Huntington. This is your radio home for Pittsburgh Pirates baseball. ESPN 94.1 FM and AM 930.